Welcome to the Openkoda demo. Openkoda is an open-source insurance platform designed to simplify the process of building insurance applications. With its pre-built components, functionalities, and integration tools, Openkoda reduces the complexity of software development. What you see on the screen right now is the admin panel. Let me walk you through the useful functionalities that can help you build your own customized application. Let's start with the dynamic entities functionality. At the top of the admin panel, you can see our insurance template data model. Each of these boxes represents a table created within this template. The data model is fully customizable, allowing you to decide which tables you need, the types of attributes each table should have, and which tables you can remove or configure according to your requirements. Let's take a closer look at one of the pre-built tables, the client table. The client table consists of basic client information, such as client status, client type, first and last name, date of birth, and gender. For corporate clients, it includes company names and contact information. However, it's entirely up to you to decide what type of information you want to collect in your client entity. Adding or removing attributes is very easy. For example, let's say there's a regulatory change that requires you to gather additional client information. Let me show you how simple it is to extend your data model and add a new attribute to the client data. Each of our tables is stored as forms, allowing you to edit them directly within Openkoda. You don't need any external development tools to make updates. Let's go to our client entity and add a new field. As you can see, here is the form for client data. In this form, you can define the table name and the types of fields it contains. What's important is that whenever you edit anything in this form, the changes are applied not only in Openkoda but also directly in your database. This ensures that any updates are immediately reflected across all your applications. Now, let me add a new text field to the client data and save the changes. In the next part of the form, I can decide which of the attributes I've created should be visible on the main screen of the entity. Let's add our new field and set it as a filter option on the screen. Once I save these changes, let's see how our client entity looks now. The new field has been added immediately. The entire process only took a few seconds. This field is now visible on the screen and accessible in your database. Within each entity, you have full access to all CRUD actions so you can create, read, update, and delete each entry. The create function depends on your configuration, so you can define which fields must be populated and set conditions for certain fields to appear only when another field has been populated with the proper value. For example, some fields might be required for individual clients, while others are required for corporate clients. Here you can view records to see all existing fields, not just the ones visible on the main screen. You can also edit and delete your existing records. Filters are also available here, including custom ones like this new one we created earlier. Also, you can download filtered results or import your data directly as CSV files. Next, let's discuss the dashboard builder. In any application, it's useful to have a screen summarizing the most important information. This could include policy summaries, documentation, upcoming payments, coverage types, beneficiaries, or policyholders. Openkoda includes a dashboard builder functionality that allows you to create custom screens using drag-and-drop tools. Let's look at an example of a pre-built policy dashboard, which summarizes policy information. Dashboards consist of multiple widgets, and you can decide which ones to display. Here we see widgets for policy summary information, adding notes, viewing or printing attachments, upcoming payments, endorsements or coverage changes, clients associated with the policy, claims, and beneficiaries. The dashboard builder allows you to customize the layout, so it's up to you which widgets you want to see and how you want to arrange them. Let's use this tool to modify our policy dashboard. Each widget can be easily rearranged or removed using the drag and drop. For example, you can move the claims widget ahead of the client's widget or remove the coverage widget. Each widget is created directly within the application as a web endpoint. It allows you to summarize relevant information, such as a list of upcoming payments. We use JavaScript to create web endpoints that power dynamic and customizable dashboards. For example, one such endpoint can extract data about upcoming payments from our database, link them to the relevant policies, and display this information on your dashboard. This flexibility allows you to configure exactly what type of data is most useful on your dashboard. This means you can design any type of dashboard, such as a client dashboard that can be used as a client portal. Here clients can log in to view all the details about their policies, payment schedules, required documents, and more. Similarly, you can build an agent or broker dashboard tailored to their workflow. This might include widgets that summarize sales efficiency, assign tasks, track upcoming policy renewals, or manage claims associated with their policies. Now, let's dive into the automation component of Openkoda. With Openkoda, you can automate processes using event listeners. These listeners monitor specific triggers and automatically execute predefined actions in response. In our demo, we have two practical business scenarios where event listeners enable automated email notifications. The first example is the Check Policy End event. This event scans your database to identify policies that are set to expire in the coming days. Once detected, it automatically sends a friendly reminder email to the clients with these expiring policies, ensuring that they're informed in advance. We can personalize this email by, for example, adding a contact for an agent who is responsible for that client. We can also schedule a scan to run every day, so that, for example, clients with expiring policies receive a reminder at 1:45 p.m. Similarly, we can implement a check payment overview event. This event will scan the database to identify payments that are overdue by more than 7 days. For such cases, it will automatically send a friendly reminder email to inform clients about the overdue payments. The email can include details such as the payment amount and a helpful link to complete the payment. This automation is fully configurable. You can decide which types of events trigger specific actions. For example, it could be a helpful email sent to your brokers with a list of potential clients they need to contact, a thoughtful birthday email sent to clients on their special day, or a notification to an underwriter informing them that a new quote has been assigned and requires their attention. The email design is fully customizable and easy to edit. Let's take the payment overdue email as an example. You can modify the email's text, adjust its formatting, and specify which data is pulled directly from the database to populate the email. Once saved, the updated email will be applied immediately, and from that point on, the email will look completely different, reflecting the changes you've made. We can also define the time frame for a policy to be considered ending soon. In our example, this is set as a 7-day period, but it is fully adjustable. You can modify the number of days in advance for the system to check for expiring policies and determine what email should be sent. Same for payment overdue reminders. In the next step, we'll discuss the security features of the system. Within Openkoda, you can define multiple organizations within a single instance. In this demo, we have two organizations, My Broker Company and Broker Shield Company. Each organization has its own customizable home screen, allowing you to configure elements such as the logo, colors, and the content of its tables. For instance, you can define team members for each organization, upload a new logo, change the color palette, or invite new team members to join. Within each organization, users are assigned specific roles. You can create any role you need, assign different privileges to those roles, and then assign them to users. For example, my user, Mark, has two distinct roles across these organizations. In Broker Shield Company, I am assigned the role of finance manager, while in my broker company, I am an agent. These roles significantly affect what I can see and access within each organization. Let's take a closer look. In Broker Shield Company, where I am a finance manager, I have access to financial entities such as cost centers, payments, and expenses. However, in the role of an agent within this organization, I would not have access to this information. In the second organization, My Broker Company, where my role is agent, my access is more limited. I cannot view expenses, payments, or cost centers. Instead, I can only access the entities specifically assigned to me. Moreover, the system doesn't just limit access to entire tables, it also allows for restrictions at the content level within those tables. In my broker organization, I am only assigned as an agent. When I access a quote, I can view basic information, such as the status, type, underwriter comments, and where the quote is currently in the process. On the other hand, within Broker Shield, I have broader access. For the same quote, I can also see risk scores and risk factors assigned to it. To summarize, Openkoda allows you to securely configure your system and control access based on user roles. This ensures you have full control over who can view what within the system. Another useful Openkoda feature is the AI reporting tool. It is important to remember that the database structures and the database model you are creating are fully configurable. You have full control over its design, and each time, we are transferring this information to the LLM model. However, it is crucial to note that we do not share any personal client data or the content of the database with the LLM model, only the database schema. The tool converts your natural language queries into SQL queries. Let's look at an example. Say you want to view all agents who signed policies this year, the number of policies they've sold, and their total value. You simply input this query in natural language, and the tool generates a corresponding SQL query. I can then preview the report, and here is my simple efficiency report. This allows me to see how many policies each agent has reviewed and the total value of those policies. Since I pay my agents a commission based on the value of the policies they handle, I can use our reporting AI tool to enhance the report. By asking the tool to extend the report, I can include the commission amounts owed to each agent, calculated based on the applicable commission percentage. I can simply input, calculate, and add commission value. We can view the report, which now includes additional information about the commission amounts that should be paid. This report can then be downloaded and shared with the finance manager or the financial department responsible for processing and paying out the commissions. Additionally, we can always view the SQL query behind the report. If we are familiar with SQL, we can edit the query and apply changes immediately. For example, let's make a simple change by renaming a column from total value of the policies to total value and reload the report. The column name is updated instantly. We can save this report with a title such as Monthly Agent Commission. Once saved, it will appear in our list of reports. From there, we can view it, and it will automatically refresh with updated data whenever accessed. With Openkoda, you can also create custom forms that can be embedded seamlessly into your website or used directly within the system. In this demo, we have two types of forms, one for raising a claim and another for creating a new policy record. Here's a simple example of a form. It can be fully customized to match your design preferences, and you can apply as many validation rules as you need. For instance, you can enter a policy number, which the system will verify if the policy exists and identify its type. Based on the policy type, the form will dynamically adjust. For example, if it's a car policy, the form will request specific documentation such as accident photographs or a detailed description of the loss. If it's a health policy, the required documentation will differ accordingly. This flexibility allows you to completely tailor the forms to suit your specific requirements. This is a simple example where you can enter details like the date of the accident, the claim amount, upload pictures or PDF files, and provide basic contact information such as phone and email. Once completed, you can submit the claim. Now, let's take a look at the email that was sent. It is a personalized confirmation that the claim has been received. It includes the assigned ID number and a confirmation letter generated as a result of submitting the form. As a result, the claim record was automatically created here. This includes details such as the accident description, status, reporting date, and claim amount. The system can automatically assign the claim to relevant parties, or it can be done manually. For example, in this case, I can assign it to Mark. A similar process applies to creating a new policy. For instance, we can start with a specific form tailored for travel policies, where it's important to provide details about the type of trip being taken. For a car policy, the form can capture basic information about the vehicle to be insured, or for a device policy, details about the device. These forms can be designed as a single-step form with all fields visible at once or as a multi-step process where information is provided gradually. Validation rules can also be applied, for example, ensuring that applicants for car insurance are not under 18 years old. Let's say I just purchased an item. Here, I can select a policy variant from the available options in the system. The dropdown automatically updates to include any new product types added. I'll enter my details. And now I'll send the policy details to my personal email. This is my confirmation along with the policy document, where all fields are fully populated. We've also integrated a web endpoint to calculate the amounts, create a payment schedule, and include it within the documentation. We were able to generate this document using another powerful Openkoda feature, a document generation tool. It enables you to create useful templates in either document or Excel format, which can then be automatically populated with data from your system. Earlier, I sent a confirmation email for a car policy. Now, let's take a look at the raw template to see how it's structured. This is a raw document where we define placeholders. These placeholders can take various forms, a single value, a list of values such as coverage names, or even a table. Let's see an example of how this document looks once it's generated for a specific policy. It can be automatically created from the data filled in the form and attached to an email, just like in our previous example. The document is created with a single click. Let me show you. I go to my policy table, where I have all my policies listed. I'll select one for a car policy. Here are the details. The policy has an annual payment of 770 euros, and two payments have been generated for it. The client assigned to this policy is Linda Thomas, and here we can see all the important details. Now, let's generate a document with a single click. The generated document is ready, containing all the details about Linda Thomas's policy that we just saw in the client view, including list of coverages and a table of payments. Let's compare it to the template file. Here's the raw template with placeholders, which have been replaced with the corresponding values in the final document. Using this template, you can generate any type of document, not just policies. It could be a standard agreement with a broker, a company policy, or a claim confirmation. Thank you for watching this demo. If you'd like to learn more about Openkoda, check out our channel or contact us via email and explore how Openkoda custom solutions can fit your specific needs.